or they try to.
What in God's name is going on in here? What was that ruckus?
What ruckus?
I was just in my office and I heard a ruckus.
Could you describe the ruckus, sir?
Turn the fucking beat up!
What is that? What is that? What is that noise?
What noise?
Really, sir, there wasn't any noise.
The Alpine's bumping, but I need the volume higher.
Bring the motherfucking ruckus! Bring the motherfucking ruckus!
Turn me on till I earn them on, let's get it on.
Stop banging on the damn furnace. You hear me now? This is the last time.
What up, doe? It's your boy Low Gross, also known as Big Papa Skeetor, and you are tuned in to episode 312 of the Inaudible Ruckus podcast. Okay, on this episode, I got the Inaudibros. We're going to catch up with E-Ray as he gives us like a little synopsis or a recap of him hanging out with the WrestleMania festivities up in Dallas. Smiles is back now. He's going to explain to y'all why he's been away. You know what I'm saying? It's all good. It's all good news. And then we're going to talk a little bit about these student loans being pushed back, man, and what that means or how it's impacting us. And ultimately, man, we're trying to figure out why they don't just go ahead and just cancel them, because clearly they don't need it. Ask Ukraine for it. Then we're going to do a little compare and contrast between Snowfall and Atlanta, because those is kind of the two shows right now that's really, you know, encompassing and capturing our culture, you know what I'm saying, on a major platform. And then we're going to have a serious talk just about overcoming adversity to, like, get to where you want to be at in life, man. We kind of stumbled upon that, but it was a real good conversation. You feel me? I do want to leave y'all with this, though, man. Like, you got to have accountability, man. Like, that's how the lessons are learned, right, and holding yourself accountable. A lot of times we don't want to feel that ouch, or we don't want to feel that pain. We don't want to feel that rejection. But that's where the lesson is. And then you hold yourself accountable to, like, just learn from it and then recognize it so that it doesn't happen again. Or if it does, then you know how to handle it better. But we'll talk about that. If you keep listening, if you stick around long enough, that'll be the conversation. So yeah, make sure you go to inaudibleruckus.com/shop, cop you some merch, cop the Naturally Nay Hair Moisturizer Dualist on there as well. We got the members only hoodies, we got the Consistency Pack, man, we build it. Then also we got on midnightclubmerch.com, we got the Run with the Wolves pack, we got water bottles, we got t-shirts, we got this new duffel bag. It's hard, man. Y'all gotta go check it out. Go check it out. And if you haven't already, go on YouTube, subscribe to Inaudible Ruckus podcast on there. We're trying to do more like vlog content and just come up with like with more visuals, trying to get back to getting more of the show on there as well, because clearly that's where it's headed. You know, I've been fighting it. I'm like the old man on the porch. We don't need YouTube. We need YouTube. You feel me? But yeah, so keep it locked. Make sure you subscribe everywhere where podcasts are. You know what I'm saying? Just Google Inaudible Ruckus and just subscribe somewhere. I don't want to hear, by the end of this year, I don't want to hear nobody say, where can I find it at? I'm everywhere. You feel me? And then the shows is growing too. But anyway, more on that later. Keep it booming. It's Inaudible Ruckus, motherfucker.
All right, y'all. You already know what time it is. Get ready for the most electrified man in podcasts. So put your headphones on and sit back as we get ready to bring the ruckus, motherfucker.
Give me the mic so I can take it away.
Now the party didn't start till I walked in, and I probably won't leave until the thing ends.
I'm back, motherfuckers.
See? What up, though? It's Big Papa Skeetor. This is episode 312 of the Inaudible Ruckus podcast. I'm back with the Inaudible Bros. I got E-Ray. What's good?
What's good? The quasi bad guy, the Diet Coke of evil, the side god of pod, the pod Hercules, the star of Wale Mania, so some say. I'm in here. What's good?
And then back by popular demand and from his world tour, which we're going to get into that shit. We got Hollywood Smiles, Iced Out Smiles.
Yeah. It's your boy Smiles. I'm back, you know, a.k.a. Hip Hop Adam Schefter, a.k.a. LaJosh James, a.k.a. now known in Alpha Land as the Pace Setter.
Oh, that was your thing?
Pace setter.
Oh, the A-C-E is capitalized?
Yeah. Oh, okay. Yeah. Fancy.
Oh, right. Oh.
So I thought of something real quick, and I got to go back, because Y'all did an amazing job. Because people don't understand, and we've brought this up before, but I have to place emphasis on it again. If you in this pod sphere, your AKA's got to be crispy. And I'm not talking about Alpha Kappa Alpha. I'm talking about your aliases. Y'all represented on For All Nerds, man. Y'all even, they, yeah, was like,
they,
oh, shit.
They was like, oh, damn, all y'all got AKA? They was like, yeah.
So to answer E-Ray's point, because y'all know I do a terrible job. Well, I don't do a terrible job, but like, I do an amazing job. I got to do a better job of finding, instead of doing the other thing that I do when we come on here, right? So I'm going to start leaning to the AKAs too. You feel me? And I feel like I got some fire ones too, but I don't be flexing on people because I just be trying to get us in and get us out and shit. You know what I'm saying? So this is the final list, because remember, we was trying some out. Y'all let me know what y'all think. We go from there, right? You ready? Or y'all want me to run it from the top as if it was game speed? What y'all want me to do?
Game speed.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Right. All right, what up, though, bitch ass niggas? This is your boy, Big Low Gross, also known as Big Papa Skeeter, also known as Big Hollywood Skeet, aka Skeety Green, aka Skeet and Cigar, aka Skeet Wick, aka Skeet Belichick, take the air out the ball just so I can flex, aka Skeet Bandicoot crashing through the box, aka Skeeter Bill, aka Professor Skeet, aka Pod Lord Infamous, Mafia, yes. yeah.
Getty Green Giant.
Y'all said somebody else was the Getty Green Goblin. I didn't want to take.
He was Getty Green Goblin. I was like Getty Green Giant.
Okay.
This shit. I like that one.
Okay. I'm gonna add that in.
I like that one.
Yeah.
Well, kind of, because I mean, Stringer Bell did some bitch ass shit towards the end of The Wire, and it was just
he was trying to elevate.
Yeah, he just got.
Hey,
niggas need to be going out buying funeral homes. Nobody thought of that. Everybody want to buy a barber shop or a laundromat. They go buy a funeral home. You ain't never going to be out of business.
Listen, the last time I was in Cleveland, unfortunately, I seen how true that was. This nigga was wilding out. Yeah, you know, I do an 8-ball of coke and so on. I'm rich. And I was like, yeah, this nigga take care of all the hood funerals. So, yep. Salute to you, crazy man.
Crazy man.
Neither here nor there.
He be in there making a peanut butter and jelly sandwich next to the dead body like it's nothing. He be offering it up to have some. You don't want it. You're dead.
I would not be surprised. That's all I'm going to say. I'm not even putting their business out there like that. It was a wild time. Let's say that. But guys,
yes,
we are back. It is another episode of Inaudible Ruckus. And so much has happened.
Nick.
I'm exhausted. I am trying my best to get.
I'm crying for like 2 weeks in a row.
Nigga, like I'm not built for this no more. I'm like a Betamax. I'm out of commission. Throw my ass away.
Yeah. Put me up. So no, give us a little recap. So last time you was in it, right? You had more events to go to and stuff. Just give us a little recap of like how it was for like WrestleMania and just some of the events, because you was out there functioning.
Right. So. Thursday, we just came off of Thursday talking about Wale Mania. Me and Smiles had a fucking grand old time. I'm sure they're about to drop the recap of Wale Mania, and Maya's gonna be posted front and center like a goof all over the place having fun. But fuck it, because I was in there. Now going on to Saturday, because they switched the alignment. Saturday was NXT in the morning. It was like it started at, I think, like 11.
Wrestling and breakfast.
Nigga.
Wrestling and breakfast.
And I did not get off work, so I had to think quick. Like, I don't know. And I was just like, all right, log out.
You just logged out from work?
Like, fuck it. I got sick time. Y'all gonna have to deal
I thought you used sick time. I thought you just meant, you know what? I ain't feeling this no more. Delete.
I'm going for the rest of the day.
Yeah. And they asked me like, yeah, well, what happened with, and I was like, yeah, I just wasn't, you know, and yeah, I just was gone for about 3-4 hours.
You a real one. Like, you a real one.
Hey, I paid some money for them tickets. I'm going to see the event. Luckily, and I'm mad because I missed the first event. First event was a 5-man ladder match one of the gentlemen I took a picture with that night before Wale Mania, Cameron Grimes. Congratulations. He is now the North American champion, the same belt that I wear, the maroon and gold belt. He won that on the ladder match. It was a fantastic match. It was crazy. By the time we got there, It still was so many more matches. Had great seats. Had to kick some white people out of my seat. Oh,
because you know, you know, you know how people. Hold on, real quick, before you get into, why do people do that? These are assigned seats.
You know why they do that?
They think that nobody gonna say nothing.
It's the gander.
I got you.
Look, if I did what I was supposed to do, I wouldn't have got no pictures with none of the wrestlers. I wouldn't have got no real drinks.
Yeah,
I was just, you know, gandering around. Like, hey, I belong here.
Gotcha.
So, look, if you just sit, get in where you fit in, after the first match, that match was so lit. Shit, I ain't see nobody down there. I would have been sitting right there, too. And it just so happens, my favorite thing is to put white people in their place.
Hold on, did they act shocked? Did they, what? I mean.
No. Oh, no, no.
They knew they was wrong?
Knew what it was. Mm-hmm. And he was salty. It was funny. Fucking shit, I told you. We shouldn't even. And I was like, and I was making sure. I'm like, wait, am I? I was like, wait, hold on. Maybe I'm in the wrong valley. Like, maybe the section 104, not 105.
Yeah.
Like, cause I don't know. The ring is like right there, and the stage is right there. So we get to see everything. People coming from the stage doing the entrances. It was lit. So me and my girl, we there. We having fun. We got the belts on, and we had a good old time. Some random guy from Wale Mania apparently recognized me from wilding out in the crowd on Thursday night. He's just like, hey, man, thank you guys for coming out and supporting Wale Mania. And I'm just like, damn, I was lit. I don't know you from my campaign.
You don't know what you did.
At all.
He know your whole name and stuff. Hey, yeah, man, the bad guy, right? Let's do some lunch.
We took a picture together. Videos. You don't remember?
Man, you were off the chain, man. Hey, those other girls, man. Huh? Right. Yeah.
Cause I was right in front of the ass shaking, like, boo, 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 boo. So all that great shit happened. And that was that. End up going to a nice little restaurant afterwards, finished the work day, then went to a nice restaurant so we could watch night one of WrestleMania from home.
Okay.
Because we was like, look, we only doing one night, because we wasn't sure if it was gonna be fire or not.
Mm-hmm.
So we went to like a little tapas restaurant, got to eat real good shit. I had like an Icelandic hot dog, some fucking rabbit stew ravioli.
Y'all bougie,
some
bougie.
Alcohol. Yo, yeah, nigga. I told you, whenever y'all come down, y'all can get down with the get down. We be scouting beautiful places to take our out of town homies.
I got
the out of town brethren and sister fam. So
right, I was like, y'all been here a year. Y'all know all the nice spots.
Right. Smiles be thugging it in the hood.
Right, Smiles are like, this Waffle House right down the street. Let's go. Word, that works too though.
Yeah.
You know, we was kicking in there, had some nice drinks and shit, talking alcohol and shoes, watching the shits. Shout out to Bianca Belair, new women's black champion.
Once again,
beautiful match. She had the match of the weekend, I would say. Stone Cold came out and actually had a whole match to end the show at night one. Incredible.
I saw that botched stunner that him and Vince did.
That was night two.
Okay. That looked like two grandparents. It looked like when your grandparents, all right, do that one thing how we used to do it that one time. All right, come on here. Come on, Vince. All right, now Steve, watch it now.
Take a good stunner.
But yeah, that's true.
Vince never took a good stunner. He always, so I was waiting for it to be even worse, and it was worse. Yeah. But it was probably slippery, all that damn beer everywhere. Steve,
because he was like,
what? What? They toss some beer, and I was like, man, this nigga Steve got hands like Amari Cooper or something. This nigga snatch, he'd be snatching them damn beers out the air.
Well, that's because that's what he do. That's probably how he receives his beers at home. It's only allowed to be thrown at him
through a jugs machine.
Yep.
Just snagging
more, another.
What?
Give me what? Another hell yeah. Give me one more hell yeah.
Hell yeah, man. But that shit was crazy. Then Sunday, of course, I had some free time. We went to brunch, had a nice little kick it session, had, you know, good food, then got ready, got our shirts, then drove down to the stadium for WrestleMania live. We got there. Okay. So as we get there, of course, I don't know what she says, tickets are riser seats. So I'm like, oh, shit, we might be up in the boonies, but whatever. We just here enjoying the energy.
Yeah.
I'm all about the energy because of this WrestleMania. They're like, oh yeah, you're on the floor. You got to go down here. I'm like, what?
Oh, yeah, girl. Yeah.
Big Ari.
Hey, listen here, Big Ari. All right.
Shit.
You know what's gonna happen when you get home.
You better bang, 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 bang.
Don't you know it? Don't you know it? And shit, we sitting there down on the risers, like row 13, shit. Enjoying. They had the big ass
high fiving the wrestlers as they getting in and out of the ring and stuff. Good job.
So we on the risers, so a little bit elevated, so we can see. But you know, the floor seats is a little bit further down, and those are the people surrounding. So we had a great like view of everything, like the entrance coming in, all that stuff. And then the best part to me, that we were right in the perfect place where they give you like the little QR code. Now you can just order your food from the seat.
Yeah.
And I was like,
you ain't gotta keep getting up and stuff.
Status.
Yeah.
Hell
that's
yeah.
That's the world that we live in.
Send me some nachos. What? That's only for them seats.
Though. I got you.
Yeah, like, send me some nachos and give
cheese
me
cheese and nachos. F6 cheese and nachos.
Exactly. I'm here. Right, give me a Topo Chico hard seltzer.
That's dope.
We was smashing. Great fucking event. Yeah, like you said, Stone Cold came out again. Just ridiculous wildness. I bought a bunch of shit from the gift shop. Triple H came out. Like, it was everything I could have wanted and asked for in a WrestleMania. And I thought about it, 77,000 people in that bitch. No mask in sight. COVID's over.
Yeah.
COVID is dead.
Yeah, because since you know I work for the Cowboys, they emailed us like the next day, like, WrestleMania breaks world record for most attended people at the Dallas Stadium. Like, of course they broke the record because Texas does not care about masks,
right.
Vaccines, none of that shit.
Well, hold on. We stumbled on something. I wanted to ask y'all this question. I was saving it for the pod. Because we Midwestern guys, you know, Detroit, Ohio, Cleveland, like Akron, we in this thing, right? Is Texas, the state of Texas, is that a cult?
Dude, elaborate, please.
Like,
I don't think you have to like walk like.
Nah, I mean like it's its own like it's like, and I only asked that because at work they was talking about they have their own Pledge of Allegiance and stuff like that. Like it's what, and I'm like, what, y'all have your own what? Like, and it's not like, oh, every state has, they have the American pledge, and then you have Michigan, and then there's like, it's like, nah, it's Texas, nigga. Like, and then think about it, somebody told me their flag is the only flag that's allowed to be flown as high as the United States flag. Yeah. So stuff like that.
And I
learned, okay, and we know this, Texas is, you can sum Texas up to like four things, really. It's like, okay, they love God, they love football, they love beer, and they love guns. And you can add some other stuff there, but like, so I'm asking.
Yeah. Barbecue.
Barbecue too. All right, so five things.
Yeah.
These five pillars, right? And it's like, this is how you get initiated.
Oh, wait. And racism. No. Control the women's bodies. They fucking love making you have children.
Well, that's the movement. That's like, I'm saying. But the overall cult of like, you have to, if you want to live here, you have to partake in those five things, or like you have to do what Texas does to like. So I just want to ask, like, do y'all feel like it's just like this thing, this cult?
Oh, yeah. I mean, we have our own fucking energy grid that's off of the fucking America. They're like, we could be our own country. The United States of Texas.
And that's not wrong. That's not wrong, right? But what makes it a cult is because it's literally like, it's us and fuck y'all. Like, they actually act like, they say, oh, we could be our own. They act like they're their own country.
Yep. That's the thing. I don't think it's a cult. I think it's delusional enough to believe it's its own state, like own state.
Yeah, they a sovereign land.
Being. Yeah, not just the state of the United, of course, its own state, but its own state of being.
Yeah.
Like, we don't, whatever y'all
do, we don't need none of y'all.
Slavery wasn't even real. Slavery was called indentured chilling for black people. They just should be making up shit. Texas Instrument. We got our own books. We just be making y'all
our own calculators,
whatever sounds good. And then, back in 1962, Columbus came back and found the black people. He's like, wait, what? That's
Christopher Columbus was born in Austin, Texas.
He was born in Austin, Texas.
Right. And then wheelchairs were given down from the high heavens. Like, wait, what?
Who wrote that? Well, no, NASA. NASA is based out of Houston, and man, I'm trying to tell you, if it wasn't for Texas, we would not be able to have gone to the moon.
Like, you God can, damn it! You can be certified as a gun owner at 11 years old.
Shit. Yeah, or if you ain't got no legs.
Yes.
All right. Just saying.
All right.
can roll your ass out to the range.
In case they roll up on you, you never know. Right. You filthy animal.
They hate you.
You asshole. Smiles, stop. All right. So, Smiles, you have some good news, too. We're going to get, for the listeners out there, we're going to get into the shit. We just got to catch up a little bit. This is how we roll. I don't know. This is the new Inaudible Rugs. Welcome to the Inaudiverse. Okay. Smiles. You have some news that or some big things that happened to you. Would you like to share with the Inaudibles?
Yeah. If fully all the Inaudibles, if you haven't seen them on the social medias and all that, the reason I ain't been on the episodes for the last like month and kind of iffy those couple weeks even before then, it was like, your boy is now officially a member of the fraternity, Alpha Phi Alpha Fraternity Incorporated. You know, got pledged in March 13th. You know what I'm saying?
Okay.
You know, just a long time coming for, at least for this chapter. I've been trying to do it for about 4 years now. Okay.
So you went to college again? You went to college again?
Okay. Yep. But, you know, it started off as 14 of us, but, you know, ended up being 12, you know, 12 in, 12 out. Me and two other guys were our alumni chapter, 9 guys with the undergrad, 7 of them were with 1 chapter, and 2 of the guys went solo. You know, but 12 of us, 12 in, 12 out, you know. And I got 11 new brothers, you know, a couple older brothers, got some younger brothers. You know
what I'm saying? That's what's up. So, question then, because, you know, we all went to college. I mean, everybody, if you listen to us, you should be familiar with like the Divine Nine and all of that stuff. So, of all the different organizations, what made you like go with Alpha?
Really just seeing them, what they was like down here, because at least the chapter I'm with and a couple of the Dallas chapters that I've met, they really about the community service. Like,
okay.
Other ones that's I know here, they really just about the partying. And I'm like, yeah, or they just not well known in Dallas because they don't do shit. But it's like one other one that's here in Dallas is really just known about the parties. I'll never hear them do nothing.
Oh, so
community service.
It's like a gang there. Y'all got like beef amongst the different sets within the same organization and so on. Oh, that chapter whack over there.
Yeah, I've learned that.
What?
Hey, what's up, y'all? It's Neezy here. I wanted to make sure that y'all go and get your Naturally Nate Instant Moisture Duo. That's right. You know, this Instant Moisture Duo can be used on braids, locks, twists, beards, and all of your natural hair. The moisturizer is all natural ingredients. One of our key ingredients, aloe vera. You know, aloe vera is really great for your scalp. And our oil blend is a mixture of the best oils that you can use to promote hair growth and give your hair a good shine and overall just a natural glow. So you're getting 2 amazing products. Make sure you go to inaudibleruckus.com/naturallynay. And also you can follow us on Instagram at naturally_nay, N-A-E-E.
Smile said that, not me. So if any of the alphas are listening, man, don't run up on me. Next question. So like, again, and I only what you can say, like what they had you do, like ice skate barefoot, you know what I'm saying, with a ape mask on, like you know what I'm saying, like can you share?
I just had to study. That's it.
Yeah, I was like really just a lot of studying.
Oh, that's what they tell you. All right, that's the response they give you. Okay.
Yeah, I learned about I learned about 7 poems, know the whole alphabet.
Did you get a gorilla mask?
No.
Oh, you need to go talk to whoever is in charge of your chapter, because if I don't get a mask, I don't want to be a part of it. I need a mask.
It's like, no, just make that face.
I know, you just make the gorilla face.
Well, I'm happy for you though, man. As with anything, man, any, because I know behind the scenes, you know what I'm saying, how you were working at it and stuff. So to see you achieve your goal, man, like, I'm proud of you, dog.
Yeah, absolutely. And I will say, I told y'all a couple weeks ago, after talking to my therapist, she really opened my eyes to the fact that, yeah, if you work this hard to do this, everything else you want out of life, you can do the exact same thing.
Yeah.
She was like, yeah. She was like, you said you want to get in shape and get fit? All right, cut all that extra stuff that you did to do that. Yeah. She said, you want to do better with your podcast and start focusing more? All right. Cut all the stuff you said You did the Pledge of Fraternity. Do that for you know, your podcast.
Let
you
want to read more books? Let Low right, yell at you. Yeah. Let Low keep yelling at you. And then E-Rez going to yell at you, too.
So, yeah, I definitely was like, it definitely has put a new perspective on life. And then even when I went to go see my barber today, because before,
this nigga Smiles walking through the balance with his chest out. So, hey, how's it going, black man? Hey, all right. Hey, sister. Hey, yeah. All right.
When the next meet? Give me a lace front, high top.
Yeah. He saved the cat out of a tree before he walked into the barber shop.
Yeah, because my barber, like, I'm used to seeing you, once a month to come get your good. He was like, ever since you did this whole pleasure thing, I didn't see you about four times in the last 6 weeks. I was like, yep. He's like, yeah, this alpha thing, you got to look on point. I'm like, uh-huh, I got to look on point now. I can't just be looking like a bum like all the time.
I'm in a fraternity.
Right. He was like, hey, I don't care, as long as you keep paying.
Right. That's what's up, though. That's what's up, man.
Raise them prices on you,
right? You know you got money now, because the alphas is considered like in the hierarchy of it all. They consider like the sophisticated ones and all that. So they know, like, they the lawyers and the politicians and stuff like that. So, I mean, there's others, but like that's
I like to tell. I like to tell folks. Definitely learn that they tell us doing it. Alpha is a business. At the end of the day, the night we cross. The guy, the president of our chapter, he literally was like,
they passed the collection plate around.
Y'all got them 2-year dues, right? He like, huh? Like the check y'all supposed to, that y'all asked for. He was like, yeah, y'all got that, right? I'm like, yeah, got it in my car. He was like, yeah, go get that. Yeah, go.
Why is it not in your pocket?
So what you should have did was, if they would have gave you the 8 mask, you could have went back to the car. You could have grabbed the, you know what I'm saying? They came back in there and be like, all right, everybody. Don't do that. Just jokes. But proud of you, dog. Where was I going with this? Oh, no. So you was talking about the discipline and kind of the journey in getting to this point. And I just want to take a little sidetrack, because we have all, on this podcast, free included, right? We have all had to kind of like push ourselves out of our comfort zone and like elevate at each level, right? Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? E-Ray, you've moved a couple times. You know what I'm saying? But like, I want to ask y'all, I'll start with you, E-Ray. Just what do you think as far as honing in on that discipline or whatever, or like being courageous enough to just go out there? Because so many people make excuses for why they can't do things, right? I don't know whether it be insecurity, and we all have it. We all have a certain level of anxiety, even though it may vary. But like, just talk about like what it takes to just kind of fight through that and still get this shit done.
I think we're all, especially when it becomes a thing of like your blackness. Like, I know we always say like, yeah, it's, you know, white people hate when you say race. Why everything gotta be about race? But essentially you're conditioned through that lens. So for us, most black people, wherever you start is kind of where you're expected to finish, being that you stay in your hometown, it becomes that place for you. And I think it really starts with having the courage to just be able to leave and not be, you know, you have to strike out new on your own. That means what, 12 to 17 years of friendships. That's something that was just cultivated naturally. You don't realize that until you leave and go somewhere else where you may not have any family, any friends or anything like that. Man. You got to start from scratch.
Man,
that changes
about
your social, changes your whole social structure. And that might actually even change your social personality. You might have thought you were an extrovert until you get around nobody. Then you're like, oh,
I'm an introvert. I've turned into an introvert.
I'm chilling. Yeah, exactly. Yeah. So it's that type of energy. And you have to be cognizant of who you are and be comfortable with some failures, because that's how you learn. You learn through growth. And again, moving from Cleveland, that I've been there for 26 years, and just striking out to Phoenix, like, money. I'm cool. I'm go there. And I was like, I got opportunities. I was blessed enough to have a pipeline to bring others out there. And a lot of people came through me. I like to always think of myself as like the scout. I will take the bumps and shit and find the stuff and lay the foundation for other
people. You're the resource. The resource.
Right.
The resource.
I'm Spencer James.
Shout out to Spencer.
Yeah. Right. AKA Spencer James.
AKA Spencer James. The resource.
The resource.
I definitely pride myself on doing that, finding a place to get your hair cut, find the places to work out, and all the things that people may not have known, because I want to make sure that their experience is less rough than mine. Because again, like the bar says, Hov did that, so hopefully you ain't got to go through it. It's no purpose. If I did it, then you got to now suffer too. That's stupid.
Other people do that sometimes, but it's the cowboy over the hill.
Gatekeeping.
Right. But it's the cowboy over the hill thing where it's like, okay, I'm going over here to see, like, okay, and if I come back with a bunch of arrows in my back, all right, we need to go this way, y'all. Don't go that way. No. I almost got robbed over
change
here.
Change of direction.
All right, let's just go back. Let's take a break. We're going to camp out here. We'll set a fire, and then we're in the morning. You know what I'm saying? We're just going to go east.
All right, all the pain, suffering. Exactly. But
it takes resolve, though. People avoid those lumps. I wanted to highlight this because, like you said, people don't want to take the arrows. You know what? I don't want to go. It's too much. I can't. And then they go right back to what's comfortable. You got to push through the uncomfortability and push through the pain and find your new self on the other side of it.
Yeah.
So much for rewarding.
Yeah, I was going to say that's also kind of another thing I talked with my therapist about. Just, I said, with this year, it's just like, uncomfortability and consistency, that's been my new thing, because you're like, hey, you want all these things, but you're afraid to get uncomfortable to do that. Like,
facts.
Because I mentioned, I was like, I got a lot of people that believe in me. She's like, all right, so what's stopping you? I'm like, I got all my friends that say, like, yeah, you're the best, you can do it, but just something just stops me. And she was like, what's stopping? I'm like, I don't know. She's like, are you afraid of losing or afraid of success? I'm like, that might be, I was like, I'm not sure which one it is yet, but I was like, I think that's what I'm just afraid to get uncomfortable to push through for what I want. It's just, I get comfortable. I'm like, hey, even with jobs, my last job, I was there 5 years. And then I realized, like, oh shit, I'm here at Cowboys. It's been 4 years. It's like, all right, now I need to get uncomfortable. If I really want that marketing job or whatever I want, I need to get uncomfortable and start doing stuff I haven't been doing before. Like, I redid my resume. I get up at 3:30 every morning. I apply to at least 3 or 4 jobs every day before I go to work.
Yeah, see.
I apply to jobs.
New habits.
I'm at work now.
Hey, new habits, though. You have to develop new habits. And once you do those, right, that becomes you. Like, your new identity comes on the new habits. Yeah. And I was reading something, and it's like, in order to change, because it's like a wardrobe. It don't make sense to bag up all your clothes and throw them out. No. As you buy a new shirt, you remove an old shirt. Right. Yes. And then you can develop a new habit by attaching it to another, like, not your bad habits, but you know what I'm saying? Like, if I'm doing this, I can do this along with that. And then now this new habit is now part of my routine now. So,
or a counter. So, you know, like you said, if you're driving to work every day, you get a coffee. If you know, some people, that has been the thing with me and my household. Like, I'm like, at this point, caffeine intolerant. My body can't handle it. I'll go fucking heart.
I think I'm starting to get there.
My girl, she drinks coffee all the time, but she wants to lose the weight and, you know, enjoy life and get back to the fit life that we were enjoying. So it became a thing, like, okay, well, you can't do coffee. So now, because that's, you're just drinking a bunch of empty calories, a lot of sugar, a lot of bullshit. So it's like, okay, well, instead of doing that, just bring your water. Or instead of doing this, get your tea, but a different type of tea, like, without all the bullshit, because that's going to be like, okay, you need to replace it because you're so used to it, and that's how you fall into those comfortable patterns. So it's all about that. I love hearing Smile's work ethic, all the things that he does, again, with me and the podcast, and just the hustle mentality. It's funny because I don't realize the things that I do. I just do them because I was like, this is what I need to do. And then when I explain this to other people, they're just like, oh, damn, that's impressive. And I'm like, I don't see it as impressive because it's just whatever to me. But it's really cool to kind of step back from myself and be like, okay, I am doing some things. Or I'm doing
this. Looking up from the outside and you're like, oh, shit.
Yeah.
I really am doing some shit.
So last night, and I know, again, you know how we rock on this pod, man. Is this my uncle... He drives trucks, so he stopped through on his way to Laredo down by the border or whatever. So he's like, I'm finally coming to Texas, man. I'm stopped through Houston and check you out and stuff. So, like,
for the first time in like 9 years or whatever, I've been to see him, like I've been up there and stuff, but he was able to come down here and just see like how I was living. And so the truck stop is over. Yeah. But the truck stop is over by the old apartment. So I picked him up and I drove. Oh yeah, I used to stay over here. And you see how y'all know all the stories I used to tell over here about the old place. And I'm like, yeah. And I was like,
bingo.
Man. So I'm driving, you know, we talking and stuff, and then we pulling up to the new spot that we at. And he's like, cause you know my ad lib, damn nephew. And he was like, this your spot? I was like, yeah. That's me. I was like, let me go get this package real quick. Wait right here. Soak it in a little bit.
Soak it in with the
flex. You feel me? With the flex. But y'all know behind the scenes, the sacrifice and the work and the just thugging it out to get to this point and stuff, man. And then to want to go further with it, to not be complacent, because that's the other thing, right? I said that in the little vlog that I did for the Inaudible Ruckus YouTube page. Y'all make sure y'all go subscribe. Run up those notifications, man. Just hit that little bell. Ring that bell.
Yeah, smash that little bell. Like buttons.
Yeah, smash it. Smash it. When you hit that like button,
we drop a new video. You'll get notified.
But. So then it's like, okay, now I'm on the other side. I got everything that I was trying to work for. And it's like, all right, well, what's next? You know, not to even push to what's next, but just where to set my focus. And then now I can go at it. The new me can go at it at a more even pace, more refined. You know what I'm saying? And just we can take our time and it ain't no rush. We ain't up against the gun no more. But we worked our way out of that.
I say it like it's like this. It's like when you're in the gym. Do you go in there one day a week and just load up as much weight as you can? Or do you just stay consistent and lift what you can every day or every other day? What do you think is going to give you the best results?
Right.
And you put it that way, you think about your goals. It's like, yeah, if you just consistently chop the tree down, because like Smiles just said, if he's applying to three different jobs every day throughout the week, he's already hit 15 different job applications in comparison to sitting down maybe one day and be like, all right, this is going to be the day I'm about to hit all these. And then you start watching TV, you start doing other things.
So that's exactly what I was doing.
Three.
Yeah.
Maybe you get three.
It's easy to get distracted too. That's why, I want to give kudos to all of us, because it's so easy to just be distracted. Because we got to talk a little bit of shit. Hold on, because you know it's Friday, right? We make this shit look easier than what it is. Okay, I just want to be clear, like, cause let's be like, we started just doing pods, but like, we all doing like 3-4 pods a piece, and still got time to hang out with our women and live our social lives and go to work and do all this and that. So when y'all
chocolate sauce some bitches,
all right,
you gotta bang.
He back. He back. Look. Sorry. You are a refined gentleman of the esteemed.
All right.
Fraternity. You must respect women, sir.
Right.
Thanks, Smiles. Respect, we can't take you nowhere, man.
Eat them in the sheets.
There you go. All right. Yeah. But no. But like, we make it look easy. So people, it's easy to be like, oh, I would just want to come be on your show. No, go build your show. Right? But then you see, oh, wait, this is a lot of work. This is a lot of work. Hey, as I ask anybody.
Every Friday?
Friday, every Sunday, every Wednesday, every Monday, every Monday, Thursday, Tuesday, Wednesday,
the
Thursday.
The pre-work between that. That means being in tune with all the goings on of all the media announcements, all the shows that you're watching.
That's just too much. I can't be watching that much. And
guess you don't want to do.
My question that I ask everybody, because people hit me up, hey, I just need some. What can I do? How bad do you want it? Mm-hmm. What you mean? I mean, of course. Nah. Before you get in this car, I gotta know how bad do you want it? Because
do you want that?
Because if we hand you the plate and we go out here, you'd be like, you know what? Nah, man, this isn't for me, guys. Yo, Doe, let me out the car. All right. You say
I'll ask you back in.
Yeah.
This ain't no Uber, nigga. You can't hit the button. We out.
Rich ass nigga.
All right, let's cut to some music. Anyway, then we about to get into the. That was the after school special.
That was the kick. And that was that might as well be in the shop part two.
Oh,
hey. Just kicking it in that barbershop.
I got ideas. Don't worry. I got something. Anyway. All right. This first track is by the homie Alex Kane. It's called Win. And then Steppas by the RudeBoy Mafia. Shout out to RudeBoy Whomp and RudeBoy Deago. The RudeBoy Deago interview just dropped on Music Impulse. So y'all make sure y'all go over to Smile's feed, his RSS feed, and check that out. Smile, this shit was lit, huh?
Oh, yeah. Like, my man Deago, he dope as fuck. Because I was just talking like, yo, one, just we had to give you props, of course. Because we were like, yo.
I didn't have to do that. I was just trying to play behind the scenes, bro.
We were like, yo, how great is it having love? He was like, bro. Everything I do, I run it by bro first. He's like, I don't care if it's a song, it's a business idea, or whatever. I run it by him first because he gonna keep it real. And then just, I love how he just gave like major props to his boy Whomp because you know I'm a big Whomp fan and just the versatility of the project. And then you know he dropped some jewels about his next project he working on. So you know, just go check that out. You know what I'm saying?
Spirit fingers. All right. It's an Audible Ruckus, motherfucker.
Bitch ass nigga.
Bitch ass nigga.
Bitch ass nigga.
He's like, shit.
Johnny and Giuliano.
I'm trying to win. They go getting it in. They go winning again. I'm trying to win. They go spinning again. Stack it and spin it again. I'm trying to win. Trap out the Holiday Inn. They go sending again. I'm trying to win. They go tripping again. Yeah, he back cooking again. I'm trying to win. Yeah, back on the flip. Easy boost cost me a grip. I'm trying to win. Yeah, back with the shits. And your bitch back on the tip. I'm trying to win. Carry 16 in the clip. One in the head off the hip. I'm trying to win. Yeah, drip on the wrist. Put my whole face in the zip. Back on my shit. Yeah, back with the shits. About the hot box and the whip. Back with the pen. Back on the booth on you hoes. And I came back for the gold. What's on the flow? Yeah, what's the move? Drip on the wrist, it's a groove. I never lose. If I don't win, I'ma learn. Bitch, I'ma sleep, I'ma earn. Hold up. Busting down the onion at the telly. Swish a sweet henny, hot and ready. About to send the addy if she ready. Break her down and bust it, I can yell it. How you want it, Machiavelli? Got 16 in the clip, Robert Kelly. Knock a nigga noodle, hot spaghetti. Then push it to the Mac, Zach and Kelly. Yeah, curry the chef when I cook. Grinding for this off the books. That's what it took. That's what it cost for the boss. Nigga, go copy your sauce. Watch me get off. Floss on the gram and they sick. Check at the line, it's a brick. That's what it's worth. Nigga can't fuck with the turf. Kick it and roll up the earth. I'm trying to win. Nigga, getting it in. They go winning again. I'm trying to win. They go spinning again. Stack it and spin it again. I'm trying to win. Trap out the Holiday Inn. They go sending again. I'm trying to win. They go tripping again. Yeah, he back cooking again. I'm trying to win. Yeah, back on the flip. Easy boost cost me a grip. I'm trying to win. Yeah, back with the shits. And your bitch back on the tip. I'm trying to win. Carry 16 in the clip. One in the head off the hip. I'm trying to win. Yeah, drip on the wrist. Put my whole face in the zip. Back for the crown. Back in the booth, I'ma flex. Fuck it, let's run up a check. Fuck what you heard. Nigga, I got it, it's earned. Two-car garage in the burbs. Fresh off the curb. Yeah, fresh out the pot. Lonely as fuck at the top. Hot you not. Nigga, this shit don't stop. Shit, it don't sit on the pot. Hold up, hunting with the wolves, that's the groove. Bucket after bucket, that's a move. Gotta snap for something, that's the rule. You ain't talking numbers, I don't move. You ain't talking numbers, I don't move. Said it twice in case a nigga snooze. Made it out, nothing else to prove. Corporate thugging money, making moves. Yeah, and I just got me a chain. Flex on you niggas, I'm pain. Fuckers, you sane. Nigga, we come from the mud. Friction ain't nothing to us. Who got the crud? Who got the key to the streets? G-Money hopping the Jeep. Cooking that dope, yeah, getting it in. Fuck it, my nigga, let's win.
What up, though? It's your boy Uncle Skeetor, and you are listening to Inaudible Ruckus. Make sure you check us out on Apple Podcasts, on Spotify, and SoundCloud, and check out the website, inaudibleruckus.com. It's Inaudible Ruckus, motherfucker.
Tweaker.
Round made the beat, get your mind right.
Diego Carr said we got some problems, well let's do the math. Four choppers, four ARs equals a bloodbath. Glock you with the switch like a fag, got it in the stash. Nigga go against the gang, I'm on these niggas' ass. We don't do no drive-bys, we pull up like boys in the hood. Walk them down, light his ass up, stuff him in the wood. They let me off papers, thank God, nah nigga good. feeling like Pac out in Vegas throwing up my hood. Dually truck, running nigga over, I do him like shoes. Tweak out on a nigga next morning, blame it on the drugs. Nigga track record clean, but claiming he thug. On the net playing tough, nigga, what you done?
He got minis in his whip, AR with the switch. When I see him, I'ma rip, tryna hit his whole clip. I got two tryna dip, other car hit his shit. He caught one in the hip, other two hit his wig. Yo, bitch in my DM right now, tryna give me some. Thought I work at Cinnabon, my clip got a Cinnabon. High run and ride minivan with a minigun. I know where he stay, who's home? Shit. Anyway, I'm smoking, I'm stepping on pressure. Soft niggas turn killers, placed in extreme measures. Watch the toughest nigga in the building, leave up in the stretcher. Think my gun a Pokemon, all these shells, man, it catch it. Fuck is you a stepper, you ain't stepped on shit. Fuck is you a stepper, you ain't stepped on shit.
Look, 20 years in the making with my niggas. Before I was a fly nigga, caught a bullet in a thigh nigga. Trap slid down for me, that was my nigga. Original deep blocker, I ain't never been tried. Yeah, quiet as kept, you niggas get fried. Real Dexter nigga until I'm memorized. I done touched $1 million to the 10th time. If we don't get the nines in, then we ain't coming. The little shit y'all niggas doing ain't thugging. 40 bricks done mixed and I ain't bluffing. Y'all little niggas ain't nothing. Sell dope and cook greens off the same oven. Wife mad at me, say it ain't the same loving. I'm in love with the money, so I ain't coming. And I can't cheat with no woman. Gotta get this bread.
Fuck is you a stepper, you ain't stepped on shit. How the fuck is you a stepper, you ain't stepped on shit.
We back up in this thing. Yeah, see?
Uh-huh. Yep.
You thought I was... Not me. You know what I'm saying?
Back up in this thing with the pinky ring. Bitch-ass nigga.
Bitch-ass nigga. Hey, we back. All right. That was weird.
Sorry, guys. Too much fun.
Hey, look, no, hey, shout out to y'all, the Inaudibros out there being patient with me while I learn this soundboard. I got feedback like, hey, bro, cut that laugh track shit out. E-Ray gave me hell for it, and I was like, bro, let me live. And then the Inaudibros like, nah, E-Ray is right. Get that shit out of here. We don't want to hear that shit.
We don't want that bullshit.
Boo this man. but we here. So that was Win by Alex Kane. He got a project dropping next week. I'm going to debut something from that next week. It's a duck could pull a truck. And the theme behind that is it was a Martin episode where he was like, if I tell you a duck can pull a truck, then shut the...
Yeah.
You feel me? And then the track after that was Steppas by RudeBoy, Whomp featuring RudeBoy, Deago. Shout out to the RudeBoy Mafia.
Stepping on this.
So we had good news announced over this week, and I was ecstatic, and I wanted to see how y'all felt about it. Student loans got extended yet again. We were supposed to have to pay up come May, and then I think they extended it to August now?
Yeah, I think August 31st. Yeah, some shit.
Cancel this shit. Why are we having this conversation?
We didn't push it back like 4 or 5 times already. Like,
I'm not complaining, but like you've proven that y'all don't need it from us, so just, you know what I'm saying?
I'm going to be that guy. I am complaining. Stop fucking jerking me off. Just let me finish. Cancel that shit. Stop playing with me. She's like, oh, you like that? You like that? Then she stop. Listen here, bitch. Cancel the goddamn student loans. I ain't playing with you no more. Like, look, we already understand that the government does not need that shit. Nope. They are literally just
how much did they give to Ukraine? It doesn't matter how much they gave to Ukraine. They got money, nigga. You got a Picasso on your wall.
But I'm tired of every single store when I ask, do you want to donate to Ukraine? No, I don't want to donate to Ukraine. She's like, everywhere I go, do you want to donate your extra funds? Do you want to donate a dollar? No, I don't want to donate to Ukraine. What is Ukraine going to do for us if America was in trouble? Nothing.
No, I'll take it one step better. Ukraine right now, while you're trying to help them, will call you a nigga to your face.
Right. Bitch ass nigga.
I mean,
die, you bitch ass nigga.
Right. Ashken Schwaschken, bitch ass nigga.
Du hast mich der Fragen. Right. I'm with y'all, man, but I will say this. The benefit is not having to focus on these loans is, man, it frees us up to pay other debt down, man, because, I mean,
yeah.
We ain't hungry, no. Pockets ain't empty, cut.
That's what I'm talking about. Listen, I got my car. I just got sized up for my Invisalign. I'm about to have them Roman Reigns teeth coming out here, like, acknowledge me. all four. Ridiculous. I'm not going with the big Joe Budden chiclets, but I am going to like get my teeth straightened a little bit. I'm gonna keep the gap like Nas did, because I'm real. But just saying, this is monies that can be allocated everywhere else. Looking forward to new house going, like 2022 is what everybody said 2020 was gonna be.
Yeah,
2020 took a shit on the world. And yep. I'm still trying.
We grew from the fertilizer, though. You feel me? Like,
we grew from the concrete. We the roses. The grew from the concrete.
We did. Because like we said on the first segment, man, when you take adversity, right, and you just – first off, I just felt like it turned the whole world ghetto, because the circumstances wasn't nothing compared to what we was already going through. As black people growing up. You feel what I'm saying? So we pivoted. You know what I'm saying? We hustled harder, some of us. You know what I'm saying? A lot of us, those PPP loans, right? People was getting those. But it's all about how you – anybody can get money. It's all about how you manage the money and what you do with it to sustain more. Like, are you utilizing that money to create more money for yourself?
Right.
So, because you mentioned Invisalign and shit. I invested in a home defense system.
Yeah. I did that in 2019.
Like,
America,
you thought you was doing some shit.
This is Texas. Nigga,
look at my shit.
This nigga Low done turned his house to T.I.'s mansion.
every gross member in his family had one. Even Hennessy got one.
And he has one for you.
The dog has a laser beam.
Freaking laser beams on his head. Is that too much to ask?
but again, though. So to Smiles's point in the first segment, I have a little journal book, all right, that I'd be jotting stuff down. I got my 5-year plan and stuff. I had a page in there, all right? The title of the page was called If I Had a Million, though.
Bullets, nice.
No. It was just If I Had a Million, though. If I had big money, this is what I would do with it, right? So that I wouldn't get all crazy and just start spending it on a bunch of random shit, it was like, okay, these are the things that I would buy. Right, so the Matthew Stafford jersey, this, new shirts for work, because I was wearing the same shirts, because it was like, all right, fuck it, but it's okay. No, I get some new shirts. Reinvest in this, buy this, do this, get London's this, do this for Neasy this, like, you know what I'm saying? So I'm just checking off the list. So even though the money's going, it's like it's going to these buckets that I am establishing, and then I did it in such a way as I continue to get my normal paychecks. It's as if I'm not even spending the money at all. So I'm like, all right,
Yeah, that's what I'm dealing with now with all the side hustles and acquiring more, adding more. Mm-hmm. It's like, okay, if you work hard enough in these side ventures, then that kind of establishes my shoe habit and my bills, blah, blah, blah. So by the time I get my regular check, pay the rent.
Yeah.
And I'm still good.
Because here's the thing, though. That's the discipline factor. You can do what you want. Right. As long as it's not hurting you any. Right. So if if you don't want to stop spending, go make some more money. So where you ain't got to stop spending.
Yeah, exactly.
Get you some glasses. Money. You better get you some little money.
Dentist costs. Give me the cash. Give me all that shit.
Yeah.
Everything in my house looked like it's expensive. And I was like, I like it like that. So I got to, you got to work.
We ain't no brokies over here.
They're like, we'll charge you a semester of school to put you to sleep, E-Rain.
Can we talk about that a little bit? About how the dentist, why the dentist, first off, the dentist has changed. The dentist has changed. They got all the TV that hovers over you now so you can watch. Mm-hmm. But I think it's to lull you to sleep while they diddle your mouth.
Oh yeah.
You really lay there and let strange people diddle you in the mouth. I'm just.
Oh, facts. Lady was just looking like, whatever. Like, I was like, you realize you got your index and ring finger like in my teeth. I've legitimately, as an adult, that has never happened to me. Yeah. Ever. I'm like, this is the oddest, like, straight.
Wait, not even during no freaky shit? No hippie chick or nothing, just was like, ooh.
No, I'm a boy. Ain't nobody like, in my mouth. Like, what kind of, I ain't that freaking now. Like, come on, girl. Give it to that. Jockey sex. No, none of that.
You gotta bang.
He's like, my favorite thing with Big Ari is when she takes the fingers with my mouth and then.
Whoa, no. Never. We gotta lead that to Smiles and his chocolate factory over there.
Just lube it up a little bit. Just lube it up.
Nah, man. It's a wild feeling. And again, these are things we also learn that come with time because we ain't always have insurance. So
yep.
Going there.
Part of the
now,
sacrifice, nigga. I'll be all
right. Right. Hey, my teeth won't hurt. I'm good.
Shit hanging out your mouth. Can't even chew.
Chewing popcorn, you just bleed.
I'm all right.
Show them go. So it's just one of those things. And, you know, getting fitted for, they got to do the old school way. Now they have a new thing, but my dentist hasn't bought that yet. The camera, take the shit in there. Yeah. They take a 3D scan of it. It's like, oh, no, we got to do it the old fashioned way. Some lady came in, put that glove on, smack. I was like, what the hell? And she was like, here, I'm going to put this phone in here. And she's just like,
ready for your prostate exam?
All right, I'll just sit there like, okay.
Mouth watering a bit. Right.
And she's like, here, put this there. Okay. And then they dumped the shit out of the side of my mouth. And she's like, I was like, I didn't eat no breakfast or nothing. She's like, oh, it's cool. You got your fillings. You're done. Just make sure because the side of your mouth. I'm like, wait, while he was working on my mouth, it didn't feel great.
Whoa.
It didn't feel great.
Pause. But now, like as this day is going on, my mouth is more numb. So the fucking Novocaine is really, I'm just sitting there like I had a stroke. Hey, can I have some nuggets?
Wait, did Ari have to chew them first?
No, I
she chew it like a bird, and then she got to spit it back into your mouth. Here you go.
You think my household is not on this freakiness that y'all talking about? I barely like sharing drinks. Look, I went and was like, look, let me just go to Juice Land. Make my life easier. I love Juice Land. That's been one of my favorite reasons of moving to Texas because Nectar was cool and all, but Juice Land is the shit. Okay. I get the same order every time. My wild child that has the swirl of dragon fruit. And I was like, they're like, yeah, just get a milkshake or something. I ain't about to drink no damn milkshake at 11 o'clock in the morning. Like, shit, I go get me some real juice, bee pollen, all that healthy shit. Mm-hmm. And that served me for the day. Then I went to Starbucks, got a decaf. I found decaf coffee. That's my new shit now.
Okay.
So
okay.
Start rocking with that. And then, like, later on in the day, finally, when I could feel the left side of my mouth again, I was like, oh, okay. I don't feel like Marlon Wayans and Senseless and shit. So
just walking around drooling and shit.
Right.
I love you.
Give me a kiss.
Exactly. So it's just a wild experience, but it's dope. You know, I take these things with a grain of salt because I'm happy to be blessed to do it. That just dope. Got the glasses. Like I said, I go over the hill. I'm now an official Warby Parker stan. So. Fuck with the cool glasses. My transitions been rocking them all for the last month and shit.
Okay,
you know we out here we rocking. But to our point that we were making before, this only happens. This is only possible because fucking Joe Biden pushed back those student loans. Now when he canceled them, guess what I'm buying? I'm buying a fucking spaceship.
I'm buying a Maserati. Okay? I want the Audi A7.
BMW. Right, I'm getting that BMW i4 550.
Yep.
Oh, I'm wild.
The Q8. I like the Q8 joint. The Q8 truck. The Audi Q8. I'm gonna do that, and I'm gonna go back to the other place, and you know what I'm saying. Sorry about that.
Yeah.
I'm just hang on.
Shoot up my BMW, dog. Like it's all electric, and then I'm gonna charge that shit at my house with my Tesla fucking pet. My man, just wait, nigga.
You didn't even cancel see the digital display. It's got the digital dash.
Right. With, with all the settings. Like, this shit gonna look like Minority Report. You're like, what the fuck is this?
Good evening, Ethan. Welcome home. Tony right. Stark in this one.
Hell yeah. Hey. Logo walk in. Denied access.
Right.
Like, hey, hold on,
Bitch ass nigga. No allowed.
The guns pointed at you.
With the dog with the lasers.
Right. Hey, I'm laser beam.
What was you saying, Small?
I'm gonna have the crib with the clothes off the chocolate room.
Oh shit. This nigga Smile's looking
he gonna
like,
catch a case, bro.
Christian Gray. Christian Black. Christian Black ass.
Christian Brown. Christian
Black. You're still
I thought he was gonna come back and he came back nastier than
you
ever.
You saw wrong. Yeah, right.
That's what that. Tell what's you? That? What's
that's
Neo,
real fraternity life?
That neophyte pussy, like yeah, when you just cross it. Oh, I like your jacket. Ooh, let me take your dick. Right.
Oh, your jacket can break wind. You got a windbreaker. It just be breaking the wind like that.
You can break ooh, my your wind.
Name on the back, right.
You got a bang.
Hey, yeah. At Wale Mania, I saw Jade. I was like, hey, Soro. Hey, what up? Hey, yeah.
He couldn't wait. Look, he couldn't wait. He had look, he already had his hand twisted up. I ain't gonna disrespect this. He already had his hands twisted up before. He's like, hey, bro, wait until do it now. Can I do it now? He walking around to other people that he know that's alphas and stuff. Like, you know how somebody famous, you do the dap and you got to do your little gang handshake and stuff. Hey.
You see my band. You see my band.
I'm with you.
Right. Hey, but to Smiles' credit, that woman was standing there so beautiful, statuesque with all that body.
Yeah.
I would have been throwing up all types of games. Like, what up, creep? She had the TBS championship. I'm all blue. I'm like, throwing up all this shit. Yeah. She gonna give me a picture. I would have loved to be on stage with her. Like, god damn.
You sure? I thought I saw y'all on stage. I was like, all those pictures almost. You were taking. You know.
Hey, almost. 10 minutes earlier, we probably would have been on stage right next to all them in the BBL section. All them hoes was giving no energy to Wale. Like, Wale, go hire some other bad bitches because they are not acting right. They're not doing what they need to be doing. They didn't understand the assignment at all. Right. These hoes were sitting there thick as hell, just
looking
sitting
at their phones.
Look, I'm on Instagram. They look just like Low right now.
Right.
Come on, but I was trying to find the next. Now, like, hold up. You know what happened? Y'all started talking about that wrestling shit, and I just was like,
He was like, I'm going to act like I don't know about anything.
No, I'm waiting on y'all to invite me on Let Me Book the Territory so we could talk about the retro shit or the Attitude Era, the shit that I do know about.
Oh, it's coming.
Cause I know what I do like is how when y'all do talk about it, y'all will bring it up. And I knew the shit, but I don't know, because now we're older and we know the behind the scenes of like everything and stuff. So when I'm like, oh yeah, what's up? They're all, you know, what happened was they had did this, and the night before they was out partying, and that's why and so they had to change the move up towards the end. I'm like, oh, that's dope. Like, so that's,
yeah.
I be picking with y'all, but like, I get it. I fucked with it a little bit.
Yeah.
I would say along with that, I would say going to Wally Mania and just seeing E-Ray and Ari in there, like, they were all the resident like in their zone. I was like, okay, I see, I understand, because that's how I gauge who the people that Wale and Cass kept bringing out. I'm like, oh, okay, they gotta be lit, because E-Ray was like, yeah!
You was, I'm big, like, lit. I went because I was following the story, and I'm like, all right, he needs to calm down. It's past his bedtime.
Because Smitty called me off of one of them.
I got a call.
Yeah, he was like, I had to call this nigga E-Ray, because he's like, I saw you post the video Smiles. All I heard was E-Ray in the background.
He heard me. Rod Van Dam's wife came out with all these double cheeked up.
Yeah.
On a Thursday evening.
They're like, can she twerk? You like, what? What are you talking? What's twerking?
Twerk queen. She had abs. So everybody's like, okay, this is about to be a muscle bound. Then she turned around, that thing just start doing a jello dance. And I'm Smiles video is like,
you got a bang, 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 bang.
Nigga. And literally, Rod Van Dam sparks up a blunt on stage,
Smiles rolling the camera, and all you hear in the background is me like, damn. This nigga hurt. Smitty hurt me clear as hell. It's like, oh, I gotta call you. And we had a whole conversation because he hurt me while I was like, yeah, I was probably bothered. My bad. My bad, John. I forget my commentary.
Be like, calm down, sir. Calm down, sir.
But I definitely love seeing E-Ray and Ari in the environment. I was like, yo, okay. I understand it more. I'm definitely going to, especially now that, shout out to Ant with me having his Peacock vlog, and I'm definitely going to start watching some wrestling more.
I'm not. I'll just hear it third party through
you. You're executive man, so we don't expect you to indulge any more.
Are there any books? Are there any books? I'm about the absolutely. Educational history.
The Death of WCW. Great book.
I think I told this story way back on the pod before when I was faking like I didn't like wrestling, but I started with WCW. That was my introduction, and I went to school thinking like, oh, I'm gonna be cool because I'm a, you know what I'm saying? And everybody looked at me and was like, nigga, we watch WWF over here. Weak ass WCW. And I'm like, oh, okay, guys.
Your villains.
Yeah, so right. But
you're like, you're ready to talk about the technical moves.
Remember, I told you, I didn't have cable. I didn't have cable. Wait, no, WCW came with cable. Hold on.
You might have had like a basic cable. It's like TBS.
Mm-hmm. I didn't.
Was straight. Yeah.
Hold on. No. I take that back. This was before that. We had cable, had WCW, and so then I started watching Raw. Because remember, Nitro came on the same time as Raw. So you try to do the switch back, that doesn't work. Unless it's somebody you want to see real quick or you know what I'm saying? Like this match, and then you can switch over and catch the rest of it. But then I learned. So then we had that. But then we didn't have cable anymore, and Raw was off, and all I had was SmackDown. And I told you that's when the draft, and all my people were on Raw. Yeah. And that's when they lost me.
They lost me.
So. Hey, it is what it happens to the best.
Hey, bro, can I come on your pod? You think I can come on your pod? Hey, I want to be on your pod.
I wish I had some drops. I want to push all the buttons.
Can I be on your pod? Rich ass nigga. Oh no, E-Ray, you had let's segue into this, man. What did you this shit did you put in the chat on Instagram about the crazy lady and something?
Bruh. I'm still trying to figure. I wanted y'all to tell me where is Free to make sense of all this.
Right.
I always need Free to help me out and understand the caucasity. Because the world is just He just has a way to explain some of the
rage. Yeah, and break it down.
Because I don't get it either. I ain't get it either.
Apparently, and let me take a look. I don't want to be really respectful here. Instagram model Courtney Taylor stabs her boyfriend Christian Tobachuku Obelseli to death in Miami condo, One Paraiso. I'm like, I think this dude like played football or something. Not too sure, but this chick stabbed this man and then like used some type of interesting Florida rule. And now she's like not charged with anything. She's been in like a holding with, and they won't release, they didn't release her name. You know, Black Twitter got a hold of that shit. And they like, mm-hmm. bitch. And then apparently she also had an OnlyFans and she was still posting on OnlyFans while she was detained. Like, not literally her, but of course, her content, like uploaded content.
So she could still win while the bullshit was going on.
Right. And it's like, now they're claiming like kind of insanity type deal. And it's just like, I'm still trying to understand how the world works and why, you know, certain people, because just in a juxtaposition, apparently Will Smith has just gotten banned from the Oscars. For 10 years.
Yeah.
And all and he's losing a lot of projects and shit. This is for one of the world's best actors of our generation.
Yep.
For one mistake. But you had Harvey Weinstein making every type of movie possible, mm-hmm. sexually mm-hmm. harassing.
Half of Hollywood.
Women.
85% right. of Hollywood got diddled by Harvey Weinstein.
All right. Diddled or knew he was diddling and did nothing, and he wasn't banned.
Niggas like the plays the Flash. He out here beating women in bars and stealing some couples and shit.
I forgot what that nigga name is, but he a wild one too. Yeah. all these random things that are occurring, but it seems like when you're Black, the conversation is so different. So I've heard nothing but, I'm so disappointed in Will. I can never watch, you know, white people. Men in Black was my favorite movie. I can never watch that again. It's like, because you know they'd be like 6 years.
Yeah, I heard something everything. I done lost so much respect for Will. You lost respect for him? What? Why?
But it got me to thinking, in comparison to this Courtney Taylor situation. I'm like, what is it? And I was like, oh my gosh, I think I figured it out.
What's this?
With like Blackness is treated like celebrity to white people.
Yep.
So it's an idolization of how cool and how different we are than the normal person. So when you're white, you're looking at Blackness almost like a celebrity because you don't understand it. With celebrities, we don't understand that celebrities are celebrities. So we look at them, that's why we talk shit about them, but we idolize them. But we also can't wait to tear them down when they make a mistake.
Yeah.
And I think white people do the same thing to Black people because they treat it like it's like, oh my gosh, oh, he's such a good one. And if Obama did anything, oh, he smoked some weed. Oh, he's a devil. Yeah, I lost so much respect for him. And on the other end of the spectrum, white people have so much faith in like how the world works for them that they don't realize like us Black people, we never feel the same way. And anytime a Black person has that weird, like kind of coercive white thought that they would have as well, we look at them like, oh yeah, we knew you grew up differently. Because for us particularly, we know the system is unjust. So if somebody get away with something, we like, eh, well, you know, it is what it is.
Yeah. White people another like, one gets away.
How dare them?
Who can we call? Who is somebody we can reach out to?
Right. Yeah. Yep. Why didn't the police remove them?
Well, not,
the same reason why this bitch is out right now after she stabbed a nigga. She pulled a Kanye in state property too. Just walked up and yanked the nigga and then was like, oh, everything's okay. That's wild.
Remember, so we brought that topic up because remember... Well, they announced this week that the people who were charged in Michigan for plotting to kidnap the governor and all that, they just let them walk.
Yep.
Just threw it out. It's all good. I'm like, how? Like, this is a state official. This is a federal employee of the government. And it wasn't like, oh, we just said some bullshit on Twitter and we was just playing. No, they raided their militia headquarters and they had all the shits. Like, they had plans, routes.
Conspiracy.
But man, but you get caught selling some weed and they be sending you to Rikers Island.
Man.
Right. For 30 years. Nigga,
what? America, yeah. Rigged. America.
Right. America, yeah.
That's all you can say. Oh, question though. Gotta lighten it up because it got a little too heavy.
The Caucasity.
And shout out to Let Me Book the Territory. Battle Royal or no. I'm trying to think. What's the best match? Like, if we have a group of people fighting against another group of people, tag team match. But like, if we could do like 5-on-5 or is it 4?
That's a Survivor Series.
Okay, match. Survivor Series. Oh. State of Texas versus State of Florida. Who you got? Like, you could take like Trick Daddy and like who else?
I don't know. I
Florida man.
Florida man, right, Trick Daddy against Matthew McConaughey and Chuck Norris. No.
They got Cubans. They got DeSantis. They got mad BBLs just walking around, just big, ridiculous asses.
Yeah, Dr. Miami.
You got somebody who's probably foaming at the mouth because they didn't eat bath salt.
Right.
Hey, remember that? Yeah.
Like, that's
super terrifying. Gremlin. That was kind of, I know the perk was fake, but I still ate it because I'm a super gremlin.
And then you got all them dreadheads that are terrified.
Right.
Haitians. Man, whoa. Now, you don't talk about the Haitians, man. Look, I'm not about to get killed. You're not about to get me wrong. I don't know.
And
shower posse.
He just dropped today.
You said what?
Gunplay just dropped a new project. Oh, shout out to him.
I'm off of Gunplay. I like Gunplay, but I stopped listening to him a while back because it's Rick Ross stopped writing to him.
So.
Hey,
Hey, what's up, y'all? It's Neezy here. I wanted to make sure that y'all go and get your Naturally Nate Instant Moisture Duo. That's right. You know, this Instant Moisture Duo can be used on braids, locks, twists, beards, and all of your natural hair. The moisturizer is all natural ingredients. One of our key ingredients, aloe vera. You know, aloe vera is really great for your scalp. And our oil blend is a mixture of the best oils that you can use to promote hair growth and give your hair a good shine and overall just a natural glow. So you're getting two amazing products. Make sure you go to inaudibleruckus.com/naturallynay. And also you can follow us on Instagram at naturally_nay, N-A-E-E.
Look. Them versus Dallas. Dallas got a wheelchair maniac, Ted Cruz,
Shakari Richardson,
lots of white people with guns, and then like just some just thick women.
Yes, Lord.
Yeah, I don't know. That'd be good. Shit, I'll watch it. Book it.
And then on the undercard, you got Michigan and Ohio.
Right, that's more like that's one of those what was the Rockers, like Marty Jannetty and Shawn Michaels. Yeah. Like we be cool sometime. Then one of us turn on the other, yep. Throw them through the barbershop, yep. Window.
Whenever Ohio State plays Michigan, and yep. It is like, right, oh, we can't talk now. We can't talk. Who would you match the state of Arizona against?
Oh,
Kentucky. Honestly,
no. Honestly, I would put Arizona as a special guest referee to Florida versus Dallas. Yeah,
it's a mix.
Florida versus Texas.
It's a mix. Because
they all in there.
Arizona is West Coast Texas.
Basically.
It's West Coast Texas. That's wild.
Facts.
Physics. So while we're talking about black culture, one of the things, and mind you guys, I don't know if you noticed the sub themes here, but we're plugging our shows. So make sure you go follow Let Me Book the Territory with E-Ray, A-Dub, and J-Mo, as well as B-A. You know what I'm saying? They be doing their thing. But then also Binge Flicks and Chill, you know what I'm saying? Like that, we gonna record a new episode of that. But in the spirit of, because I've been holding out on some of the TV stuff because I don't want to steal none of E-Ray's thunder, but I gotta heat the skillet up, man. Because we're talking about black culture being cool, FX has leaned heavy into that by identifying Atlanta and Snowfall. Before, because you know they were at different times, but now they're running congruent, so they're trying to position it like, oh, we're fearless in our content. So which one of those shows you want to start with first? Because like two completely different trajectories and two approaches to how they have like become cultural staples or how they have not become cultural staples, depending on
or like, slid from the cultural zeitgeist to a degree. I would say let's start with what I've seen.
Okay.
Let's do a little bit of Atlanta because I will probably end up recapping that probably like one of the last episodes that we do for Binge Flicks for this season. Mm-hmm. So let's go there because it's been a long time and I think that's important to say.
How long was their hiatus? Like 2 years?
No.
Three?
It's been about 3-4 years.
It's been that long.
2016.
They didn't drop one during the pandemic.
Oh,
it's
yeah,
been gone since like 2018.
Yeah.
2017, 2018.
It debuted in 2016 and then 2018. Oh, no, you're right. Yep.
Yeah.
Damn.
I didn't think they was going to come back because all the stars was featured in all these major movies and stuff. Like, all of them damn near in the Marvel universe.
So, that's an interesting point because I was going to say, since then, we've seen, like, all of them do vastly different roles. So, it's actually interesting seeing them come back to these roles.
Yeah.
And
they're bigger than these characters now.
Yeah, and to my surprise,
season two was 2018.
Okay, shit. Look at Smiles doing his job. Did you see this?
Because I was like, this is wild. It's really been 4 years.
E-Ray, did you see this? This man actually looked it up.
I know. I love that Smiles is doing that, but you interrupt me again, I will fucking break your face. Bitch ass nigga. That's right. But I was thinking that it's crazy to me that all of these damn people have done these huge roles and it's amazing that they all I haven't went back to binge Atlanta at all.
I'm years
removed from these characters, but as soon as I watched it,
I immediately fell right back in with them. Like, mm-hmm. oh no, they haven't moved on. It doesn't feel like Bad Boys 3 to me, where yeah. it was like, this ain't Mike Lowry no more. This is just Will Smith playing.
as we saw.
Yeah. So it was different. So that's what I mean. I just appreciate, even though they've grown so much bigger, because Zazie Beetz was in The Joker and Deadpool.
Yep.
Lakeith Stanfield had been in Judas and the Black Messiah. Sorry to bother you.
Zazie was also in The Harder They Fall. Or The Harder to Kill, the Netflix joint with Idris and
the Harder.
You know what I mean.
Yeah.
The Black Western.
Yes.
Leonardo DiCaprio. One movie. Yeah.
yeah. And then of course we know Childish Gambino, Donald Glover has been all over everything.
Yeah.
Like behind the scenes, in front of the scenes, music has like tripled as well. So it's also featured in the tolls and success for all the characters, and to see them all fall back into place, and this show didn't miss a beat. Weird and surreal, but very understandably Black.
Yeah.
But just, oh, I love it.
Well, you touched on something about the fish out of water experience, because we were able to watch them kind of just, and I like, it's like the show The Game, right? They never showed them on the field. They're starting to do it now and stuff, but like when mm-hmm. it first started, we only saw what happened off the field. It was just implied what happened. Paperboy, we never, other than that one video, we never really heard actions and stuff like mm-hmm. when he was off the clock, so to speak. So to see them mm-hmm. go from just trapper, like up and coming artists, and they didn't start them all the way from scratch like how we are. See, it started like right when the first song popped and he's adjusting to the fame, right? And then so now they lit. They overseas now. They at the height of his career damn near, and it's seeing like, okay, this is what it looks like on the next level. And they're doing it in Europe. I like how it's tackling like the different and just like, okay, but we're experiencing it because if we from the hood and we make it to that level, this is how we would react to those situations.
Exactly. Like, what the fuck? Or we just being in the street like, this feels weird. And every situation is so unique but understandable. And it's like, that's so good. That's great. And just being about like purpose, feeling your purpose.
Yeah.
And all these things, all these very fluid concepts, I think they do such.
No, I was like, I'm going to rewatch season one and season two just to keep it fresh, because I was like, yeah, I'm going to wait for it.
But that's the thing. You can literally watch this season. You know who the characters are. You don't. There's no attachment to the storyline, so to speak. There's no callbacks where you would need that. But if you feel you need it, go for it. But I want to ask.
Good watch, but
so one of the things that Donald Glover and the writers are really dope at doing is how they weave in like other, like
just completely
arbitrary
situations that have nothing to do with the main character.
Yes, but it's satire and it's sub themes that they're trying to get across. It's like Blackish, but like it's more immersive. Like they not it's not meant for us going like
and that's the first episode immediately. Like it hit so hard for me, and I'm just watching it. And it was the first episode was very much like Get Out meets so many other little themes, because you're watching this surrealism of this lesbian couple adopt Black kids. Your mom saying some stuff to you that's like, hey, don't you be watching that TV? And you're like, mom, I want to get some food. You're like, ain't no cereal. It's some spaghetti in there. And you all like, man,
spaghetti for breakfast.
She's like, right, and you embarrassing your family at school. Everybody got in trouble.
No, when the grandfather slapped,
three slaps, and it was just like, and the white parent, oh my gosh, I'm gonna get you out of here.
Yeah.
And it's so surreal, because for us, it's like, no, you have to behave, and it's for a reason, because your mom is probably the only one working. She's providing for you. She's doing the best she can. So it's not going to be cereal and all this stuff.
Yeah.
And the kid didn't cherish these things. So you see him removed from the home. He gets adopted by these white.
Wait, hold on. He wasn't removed from the home. Mom was like, oh, they're going to take you? But fuck it. They can have you then.
Yeah, that's the surreal part. And not like, white, like, that's my baby. She's like, oh, go ahead. Oh, you called the CPS on me? Yeah.
They was like, man, we're not taking him. We're just here to do a wellness check. Nah, y'all want him? Y'all can have him. Go ahead.
Hilarious. And then you see him like live this other life, and you're like, man, this is these. It's funny because the couple that they set up, he's like, what's that smell? And they're like, oh,
it's kombucha.
Kombucha, and we make our own pickled sprouts. And it's like, I should say the liberal version of
slavery.
Of like, oh, we got these kids
working in our garden at the farmer's market and shit.
To go ahead and go make money to the farmer's market so we can support the family. And he's like, I'm bored. She's like, why don't you try to sing a tune, you know, while you're working in the yard? And he's like, I feel like I'm going to work. I was like, a Negro spiritual? I'm like, this is crazy.
Yeah, yeah.
And then frying the chicken. Like, it's so many things. Like, Smiles, I promise you. Watch that first episode. It's
The one this week was even crazier. So I'll give you a hint.
I'm so ready.
It's what would happen if a mandate came down that white people had to pay back reparations.
Oh, I need it.
Like a actual, like, they don't say it. You just got to watch the episode and pick up, like, people's man. Come back to the chat after you see that shit. But I want to move on, though. I don't want to spoil too much.
So,
like you said, it's a slow cook. It's really just understanding where they can hit at, where they work best. They had an opportunity to like, go off and elevate their careers and come back and still reprise these roles.
And they're in their pocket.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Let's be real.
On the flip side, though, we have a show like Snowfall, which was, and you, I will not lie. I came on here and I was not big on Snowfall early on because, remember, I was like, this is stupid. This is like, he would have been dead. And to see his character development, okay, he won me over Franklin Saint. Like, he won me over, it's cool. But now, and I think a lot of this, and I'm jumping the lead a little bit, I think a lot of this has to do with John Singleton no longer being with us, to where now it's just off the rails now. So,
yep.
Because
I agree.
It's they doing too much. I feel like there are times when they're trying to be fake deep, and I think they're trying to take a little bit of the Atlanta bag, some of their sauce.
Yeah.
There was one episode in particular this season. So it's only two. It's one episode left, and then it's a season, the season finale. And then it was announced this week that they are renewed for a sixth and final season. So to me, that just means they're about to start killing people off, like major people off.
Yeah.
They have to. And
gotta end it.
But I think that's been the knock on this because they – too many improbable situations they come out of and they don't lose anyone.
Yep.
They don't lose anyone. And that Tiger episode being the main one that everybody was just up in arms about.
Yeah. I think you have to straddle that line or you become too cartoonish. Mm-hmm. And then it's also a thing of diminishing returns. So you can only kill so many people or get out of so many situations where it's like, all right.
Well, hold on. No, so that Tiger episode, right? And for those that's not listening, I'm trying to spoil it. There was an episode where they end up in a cage with a tiger. Also, the Mexican guy and Franklin, right? Everybody, we trying to figure out how they get out. Now, they get out of this situation, but then they end up in another situation, and then it's all types of stuff. Now, people were disappointed because they were like, man, what the fuck? This is crazy, man. They all should have been dead. This is wild. There was a move that was pulled throughout that, and I was like, oh, that's a Detroit move. That's something that a Detroit dude would do. And everybody kind of on the timeline was like, oh, you know what?
That makes sense.
Yeah, okay. So, but it was still foolish. Like, it was still.
I'll say this. It's comparative to Power.
Yep.
The original Power series where it started out really good, first two seasons. Mm-hmm. Third season got a little wonky towards the end. And then it just Then it just went completely off the rails. And then it was like, Ghost is supposed to be the smartest guy. How does he keep doing stupid?
No. Remember when his alcoholism came out of nowhere? Out of nowhere. I'm a drunk and I got an anger problem and I can't.
Oh, I lost my baby, but I'm still cheating on my wife.
I lost the love of my life. I lost the love of my life.
Listen, wife, let me grieve. I lost my love. And she's like, nigga, what?
Bruh.
So, man, still go for that.
But Snowfall, also too, right? These characters, I think, are emerging before our eyes. We saw what happened with the Atlanta cast, right? But with Snowfall, I think these characters are making a name. Because is it Damson Idris? he's part of that wave of British actors coming over and playing these roles, right? And so he's making a name. The guy who plays Leon, Isaiah John, is making a name for himself. Amir Joseph, who plays Uncle Jerome, like, he's making a name for himself, right? And then they have those other people, the mom, who's very much like she's a, she's a, they anchor the cast.
They're like character actors. They're really good character actors, and they're starting to evolve and pick up from this, but I think it's to a lesser degree. And there's nothing wrong with that.
Did you say that one of the guys plays on Winning Time also?
Oh, yeah, so that's new. He's a new character. Yeah.
Okay.
I don't want to spoil, because that's a plot twist. I'm not going to spoil that part for people who may or may not have seen it. But that story arc speaks to E-Ray's point, to the cartooniness of it. You can't either buy off or just win over all of your enemies. You have to take losses, right? You got to take some type of losses and stuff.
I'm going to show you I'm smart.
Because you know who I was disappointed in, right? Because they made it like, Man Boy was a force, but they made it like Scully was about to, like, he was going to be the rapture, right? Like, he was in there listening to techno music, you know what I'm saying? Crucifying people, cutting people's ears off, doing show. You got to feel the voice.
Yeah, and it amounted to, So, and I think that's just what it is. They just don't know where to go. They lost their direction. Mm-hmm. And unfortunately, from what I heard, that show killed John Singleton. It worked him to death.
I can see that. So I will say this. I've been holding on to this take because I've been trying to give people time to like see it. I didn't know if we was going to do binge flicks for it or not. They, out of nowhere, this season introduced this new girl for Franklin that's like his like business partner / she run all his stuff. She ended up being his baby mama, and this, she is trash. You know, we be real. We watch it for the chicks. We say, all right, how they looking? All right, she not cold to me. I'm sorry. She got this strong ass face. You know, she's just Jennifer Garner jawline, bro. Like, I'm smooth, bro.
Damn.
It's just like, not cold. The other chick, the one that tried to, that Man Boy has sent at him and stuff, was colder than this one. Shit, the Melanie girl that he was initially with, like, they could have brought her back.
Yeah, they, you know.
Shit, crackhead Wanda, when she not a crackhead, is colder than this, man.
Damn. With that said, I'll give a little bit of a spoiler from another show that we will be talking about on Binge Flicks and Chill. I felt the same about the new Bel Air with Lisa. I was like, this who y'all arguing over?
Long played Lisa, y'all. And this like...
So in respect to that, it ain't hidden like that. But I will say her acting and the character they gave her grew on me throughout the season. Cause I just like, you know, it was like,
She's a good actress and she's playing the hell out of that character. Yeah. But I'm with you where I was attached to just, even knock off Tay Diggs as Uncle Phil. Now he's killing that role. Another British guy that they brought in. But we used to Uncle Phil, huh?
He a British dude too? I didn't know that.
Yep. Yeah, well, he Canadian by way, London, Canada, Island, so he like Trinidadian or something like that. He ain't, you know what I mean. But we're just used to Uncle Phil has like, he was a presence.
Yes,
right. But like his voice, his projection. This guy does a good job of it, but Uncle Phil was just like, he commanded the room even without saying much.
So I would say if we had to break down just without like really going into it, I think my favorite character, like, I think Uncle Phil does a great job in the show. I think Aunt Viv, even her tone inflection sounds like the original Aunt Viv to me. Yes. And I'm like, come on, Will. I'm like, Viv?
Cassie Freeman. Yeah. And then
Carlton was another like standout for me. I think
he's killing that role.
I enjoy him in every scene he's in, even if it's like the bitch assness or the crying.
I can't stand you, nigga.
I love it, like, all of it. So that I thought Will
he definitely got me that final episode.
No.
Go talk to Lisa. That got me right there.
I'm with y'all because I think it gives us an extra layer to the Carlton character that we didn't acknowledge back then. right? Like so that point. Also with Coco Jones playing Hillary, I think that but they just rewrote that character Coco altogether.
Smiles has got premium live content.
He does.
I got that bill.
but back to what E-Ray was saying about Will. I feel like Will does too much. Like how you said with Aunt Viv, Will does too much of trying to be Will.
Right. And missing just some of the natural nuance of the kid. Or not even nuance, just some of the natural mannerisms is not there for me. And it's fine, but it's like I prefer the Carlton role in this one.
Because he reinvented Carlton versus trying to just copy him. Like I feel like I'm watching this. Now, everybody's doing a good job. I want to be clear, right? Because one of the things in this podcast space, and I learned this from y'all on For All Nerds, shout out to y'all because y'all killed that shit. We will continue to shout that out.
Listen to that now. On Music Impulse, as well as the Inaudible Ruckus feed, there are two different versions. It's like, I always call it the slow jams, the Twista version versus the Kanye version.
Yep.
Put the Inaudible Ruckus sauce on one, Music Impulse got the sauce on the other.
The chocolate sauce on the other one. But no, like we were saying, so I feel like he's imitating him. And everybody's killing it, right? I'm trying to get out of that. This is trash. No.
Yeah.
We gotta speak to what we like, what we don't like about it and stuff. But that doesn't mean anybody's doing a bad job. He's doing an amazing job, but I feel like he's doing more copying, right? You have Aunt Viv who she's not really copying, she's just hitting those inflections, and it's a callback to that. Carlton is just straight up like reinvented this character for us. Same thing with Uncle Phil, same thing with Coco Jones as Hillary. Ashley, I think as her arc continues to develop, we'll see more of that. The Jeffrey character, right?
Yeah.
It's completely different. Will, though, and Jabari Banks is the guy, like, he has, like, I just would like to see more of him. And maybe maybe that is him, because he's a Philly guy, and he was handpicked.
John. Lots of Johns.
I had to hit the board with the John.
Because I know, I definitely, like, during this last episode, I really got the, like he said, copying, because when he went off, everybody was like, "To hell with him!" I was like, "That's literally just like the exact."
Question, and I'm sorry for hijacking, because we'll go deeper into it for Ben's Flicks, but Marlon Wayans' portrayal as Lou. Everybody's like, "He killed it!" And I was still on the fence. I was a little on the fence. I like Marlon.
I thought it was cool, but overall, I just feel like y'all just put that in there because y'all know that's the episode that everybody loves and remembers from the original. I'm like, y'all gonna push this to like a second season, like type of topic.
Well, I don't know. Bel Air might not come back because Will Smith slapped Chris.
Especially the way they teased it, like, oh, I got this envelope that has like all the information about your dad and all this.
I don't see Jeffrey reaching out to tell Dog to show up though. Like, I don't see that.
So that was my biggest issue with that, and we're gonna go much deeper into my really disdain for it. Like, I thought overall it was a good show, but that last episode for me was really like
cringeworthy.
I don't want to say cringeworthy because I did like the acting in it, especially from Marlon, but the writing itself was like, what part of this, like this, these things, the pacing, it's like you got to pace it out. If you're having these conversations, it feels like the whole series was always like, can niggas just be happy for an episode or something happened? Like, it was always drama to more drama to more drama, and it's like trying to elicit these emotions, but again, diminishing returns.
Yeah.
And as like, some people fall for it. For me, it doesn't hit me like that because I'm like, okay. Like, I like the turn from certain things, Carlton's character going from like a villain to more sympathetic to Will. So it's like they actually get bonded, which is dope. That was real rich. Yeah. His father stuff, they could have literally played it like, that's the cliffhanger that we need,
and then to bring us back,
meet his dad, and then it's like, oh my gosh, and him hitting it off, and maybe like, I want to come live with you, bam, then you set up for a second season and he'd be conflicted.
Yeah.
Then season two, you get into what really made that issue a issue, not just, oh, my dad was in jail. How does that, like, or your dad, excuse me, Uncle Phil represented him.
Right.
So, like, did he put him in jail? Did he do something illegal? Yeah. Like, it was so many things that could have. Anyway, I don't want to get into it too much.
I'm with you. It's over-dramatized. And then I think that, to Smile's point, they took all of, because Fresh Prince is in syndication on TBS. I feel like they just crammed all the episodes into like here it is, Uncle Lou. Mm-hmm. Then next, it's gonna be all American. They're just gonna be in college and he gonna be working at ULA.
I mean, look, the way I see it, Hillary is the resource. So,
right. We gotta cut to some music. All right, let's get up out of here for E-Ray. Get us canceled. E-Ray, tell them where to find the other shows at.
Listen, it's the Quasi Bad Guy. You can find me talking my shit with my compadres J-Mo, A-Dub, and newly added B-A on Let Me Book the Territory. We're on Twitter at Let Me Book the Territory Pod. Some amalgamation of that as well on Instagram. You can also find me on Binge Flicks and Chill with a new episode coming this Tuesday. Sorry for the hiatus, but listen, niggas living life. We got rest.
Oh, no, we got pod material to discuss now. Binge Flicks is from when we were sitting up in the crib and we catching up and we critiquing and then. When you out in these streets? When you out in these streets?
All right, y'all got to understand. Gotta let the chopper go. I got to make the logo like, sorry, guys, be back soon or something when I'm not dropping the episode. It just is what it is. But you can find us there. Also, I'm on the Instagrams at @E_RAY_TheBadGuy for all that great content, Ski Mask Jones and all that shit.
Uh-huh. Okay. Smiles, tell them where you got an alpha podcast, you know what I'm saying? The Ice Chronicles or some shit, like what's...
Hey, you never know. I'll be doing so many different podcasts, you never know what I might pull out. Hey, shout out to the ladies. No. Hey, but for real, you can follow me at JW Smiles on Instagram at Music Impulse, MusicImpulse, and at Shot Versus Smiles on Instagram. Don't forget to check out my new episode with RudeBoy Deago on Music Impulse on all those streaming platforms. Follow me on Twitter at Music Impulse, MusicImpulse. Ladies, your favorite Audibro, I'm back. You know what I'm saying? That's pretty much it, you know? And don't forget to check out that 4 Hour Nerds episode.
Yeah, better have both of them, both versions. All right, this next track is called Coldhearted. It's by the humble Flamborghini Gallardo, aka Flam Feeva, up out of Dayton. It's off of his album, his double album called Fuck the Rap Game. It's available on all streaming platforms. And then Satellites by the homie AK Freddy J featuring Gon Jones. And it is it's based off of Trillmatic. That album. So y'all make sure y'all stick around, man. It's an Audible Ruckus. Motherfucker.
E-Ray 316 said, I just whipped your ass. What?
Bitch ass nigga.
Try to blow them up, bro. That's cool. Let's get it.
Turned they back here, left my heart cold. Switched it up, quit picking up, I got the dial tone. All my buddies turned they back here, left my heart cold. By my lonely, got nobody I can call on. That betrayal cut me deep, it left my heart cold. I don't need nobody help, I know that sound wrong. Niggas kick me while I'm down, it left my heart cold. Broke my heart and left me singing all these sad songs. Never thought you'd be the one that played me sideways. We was smoking, dream of balling in my driveway. Coming up ain't have a dollar, but we found ways to make it happen, still you end up asking for a trade. From the bottom, I thought we would see the top together. Go from broke to ballin', hit the mall and cop whatever. Till the ties were severed, I thought I knew you better. We've been through worse weather, but when it started raining, that's when you started changing. Damn, had me stuck in disbelief with paint all on my face. Fuck nigga magic, I just saw my dog turn to a snake. 3-4 more right after that, myself I had to isolate. My feelings in the refrigerator. Turned they back here, left my heart cold. Switched it up, quit picking up, I got the dial tone. All my buddies turned they back here, left my heart cold.
By my lonely, got nobody I can call on. That betrayal cut me deep, it left my heart cold. I don't need nobody help, I know that sound wrong. Niggas kick me while I'm down, it left my heart cold. Broke my heart and left me singing all these sad songs. If you are in the awakening process, part of the path will involve solitude and aloneness, sometimes for years at a time. Most people, if not all, go through periods of aloneness, and the less you resist this, the smoother your life goes. You will either be pulled there because you voluntarily seek it, or you will be put there and resist it. But being alone is a part of the process of awakening. If you left me good looking,
I wish I was a ruler.
I needed that.
Yo, it's Uncle Skeetar, and you are listening to the Inaudible Ruckus Podcast. Okay, make sure you subscribe on Apple Podcasts, on Spotify, and on SoundCloud. Okay, you can also go to the website and cop you some merch, inaudibleruckus.com/shop. Solid dudes, solid topics, solid music. Inaudible Ruckus, motherfucker.
All I see is UFOs and satellites. I'm a steady hustler and get my cash right. Yeah, she a stallion with that satellite. Yeah, satellites. I've been steady hustling and get my cash right. Yeah, she a stallion with that satellite. Hit it from the back, hey, what's that gal up like? Yeah, satellites. Satellites. All I see is UFOs and satellites. Satellites, yeah.
Cruising past through lights and I got gas to light. I must be an astronaut, I'm seeing satellites. If this ain't what you rapping like, you need to pass the mic. They give it to me for the score like passing it to Mike. Threw on my retro Air Jordans, that's cause I'm feeling fly. Gary Payton got me on lock. Or I might rock the Air Forces, you know the high tops. Smoking on that headband, no receive wireless. Stone Cold Stunner, no Steve Austin. I be in my own world, I don't speak often. I love my haters, dilly, let them keep talking. That's a skinny ass nigga, but he eat often. I keep coughing cause I'm smoking something catastrophic. Cadillac riding while they got me sitting lopsided. Then I say cruising, I been gliding while I flick my lighter. All the smoke got niggas thinking it's something on fire. That's cause I am, plus I'm high as a sky cam. I'm either fucking or smoking something exotic. She say she wanna ride with the pilot. Got a plan with the stick in the cockpit. Gone.
Satellites. All I see is UFOs and satellites. I'm a steady hustler and get my cannons right. Yeah, she a stallion with that satellite. Yeah, satellites. I've been steady hustler and get my cannons right. Yeah, she a stallion with that satellite. Hit it from the back, ain't what you get him like. Yeah, satellites. Eyes and tank on low, stairs path for the old, dodging pole for the dough, pole flow for the boy, chopper for the jack boy. So quick to run up on ya, quick to get up off ya. What do you got to offer? Tell me before we offer. Your mama see you slaughter, listen up to the lauder. Peace tonight for certainly, that perp shit, yeah, that's tearing me. Some bonus kinda scaring me, but fuck it, it's my therapy, yeah. Pigs can suck my dick too, red and blue in my review. UFOs like an issue, satellites sending missiles. Oasis out of stendos, the devil to the gristle. But now I get the memo, yeah. Now I get the memo, yeah.
All right, thanks for sticking around, man. So this has been episode 312. As I mentioned, man, subscribe everywhere. Make sure you follow us. Tell a friend to tell a friend if you enjoyed what you heard, man. Keep rocking with us, man. We're trying to just build it out all around, you know, as we building it in front of y'all, man. So we appreciate all the support we can get. Make sure you cop the merch. So inaudibleruckus.com/shop. The Naturally Named Moisturizer Duel is there as well. Go to Midnight Club merch. And yeah, make sure you subscribe on YouTube, like, share, comment, all of that good stuff, man. Because that's how we get where we got to go. If you don't want to buy nothing, man, just, you know what I'm saying, share it and just like it. It works. You feel me? But like my OGs used to tell me, go with God and fuck the rest. It's Inaudible Ruckus, motherfucker. When I be rolling,
Vegan.